Weighing in at 200,000 kilos and stretching the length of a basketball court, the blue whale tops the big animal charts. Now researchers think the seasonal availability of its 40 million krill a day diet may have led to their behemoth size. What does the fossil record say? Researchers knew from living whale proportions that the size of a whale correlates with the width of its cheekbones. They then measured skulls of 63 extinct whale species and 13 modern species and plotted them on a timeline that showed the whale family tree. The whales didn't get to be really big early on, nor did they gradually get bigger over time. Instead, they became moderately large and stayed that way until about 4.5 million years ago. Then, baleen whales went from relatively big to ginormous. 4.5 million years ago, the biggest whales were only 10 meters long. Today, blue whales are 30 meters. What was happening 4.5 million years ago? It was the beginning of the first ice ages. And as glaciers expanded, spring and summer runoff poured lots of nutrients into the coastal ocean, fueling explosive growth of whale food. That seasonal runoff created a new pattern of food availability. Seasonal patches of very abundant food spaced far apart over the course of the year. Why would that make for bigger whales? Modern whale studies show that the more concentrated the food, the greater the feeding efficiency, especially in whales with really big mouths. Furthermore, larger whales can travel faster between patches of prey. So baleen whales that got bigger, faster, thrived, while smaller species went extinct. So for whale evolution, it's not quite you are what you eat, but close.